Hi, I'm Jennifer Lavasser, a curator here at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum, and today I'm going to be talking about the very famous Moon Man image of Buzz Aldrin on the moon during the Apollo 11 mission. So one of the first things that you can notice here, of course, is the backpack. This is the life support system for the astronauts on the moon. It's critical to everything that they do. It carries all of their water, their air, so that they could stay alive on the moon. Of course, one of the most famous things about this image is the reflection. Here you can see Neil Armstrong reflected. He's the photographer, and you can also see right next to him Buzz Aldrin's shadow. So these are really important features, but it really shows us not only the photographer, but the fact that there were two people on the moon. It sounded crazy that we could send people to the moon, and so to see two of them in this actual space makes this image and this reflection in the visor really important. Another part that you can see is the Lunar Module. So this is the vehicle that they went to the moon in. This image is described as a spontaneous image. To turn yourself around on the moon took quite a bit of effort, and you needed to use even your arms to get enough momentum. So here you can see that Aldrin is actually still moving his arm from when he had to turn from facing away from Armstrong to facing him. The other thing that indicates movement is a strap. Here you can see that he was actually quite a bit in motion. Another thing that you might want to notice about an image like this is the fact that this is the only way that you could tell which astronaut this is. This is his name tag. And of course, it clearly states that that is Edwin Aldrin, Buzz Aldrin, of the Apollo 11 mission. Another important feature of these is this little crosshair, and you see quite a few of them all around the image. These are marks that help tell distance. You can also see quite a bit of lunar dust here on the knees of Aldrin. It was very difficult to walk in the spacesuits. Of course, this is the first time these suits had been used on the moon, and they were used to do what we see here, which are boot prints. So this is the real evidence, even today, that lasts on the moon of human presence. These boot prints made by the Apollo 11 astronauts and all the way up through the Apollo 17 mission will be undisturbed basically unless humans or other things go and disturb them. This down here is a contact sensor. So this is underneath the pad of the feet of the lunar module, and this is the little sensor that actually triggered an alarm or a monitor inside the lunar module when the astronauts had made contact with the moon's surface. It wasn't understood necessarily how the lunar module would react to landing on the surface, and so the fact that this sensor actually bent up shows that the lunar surface is actually quite solid. We have things like rocks, which are obviously super important. The very first job the astronauts had to do was to collect samples. Strangely enough, it's documented in the mission transcripts that Neil Armstrong actually kind of ignored that rule, did not collect his contingency sample right away. The first thing he decided to do was to take pictures. And he started taking pictures as soon as he made that first step so that he would have some kind of evidence for everyone to be able to see that this was what had happened, this is what they had done. Up in the visor here, you can not only see the American flag, but you can see science experiments that have been put out by the astronauts. So in looking at this image and analyzing it and analyzing any image, a strategy to take and what I was trained to do is to really read it just like you would read a page in a book. You read it left to right, top to bottom, and it really allows you to analyze every single bit of the image for information you might not otherwise get from just glancing at an image or even reading text. There's lots of ways to interpret images, but there are symbols within these images that help us understand and get a deeper understanding of the events depicted in the image.